За кілька днів у Канаді вибори до нового парламенту, і ми сьогодні переглянемо, яке це має відношення до українського громадського життя в Канаді.
Багато політичних партій і кандидатів беруть участь у виборах до парламенту Канади, але більшість із них не мають значення поза межами своєї виборчої округи або своєї провінції. Основні серйозні партії в Канаді – це консервативна партія, ліберальна партія і нова демократична партія. Зараз розглянемо, яке відношення цих головних партій до українського громадського життя в Канаді.
Фокус українського громадського життя в Торонто є Bloor West Village. І тому дуже відповідно, що в програму своєї різноманітної діяльності Суспільна служба українців Канади включила зустріч всіх кандидатів виборчої округи Parkdale High Park.
Here is the format of the meeting. I'll be giving each candidate a 5 minutes to do their opening statements. I'll be posing them a question. They will hopefully stick to the topic.
Модератором зустрічі кандидатів був екзекутивний директор Суспільної служби Віктор Гетьманчук. А головне питання від публіки було про відповідне представлення Голодомору в Державному музею людських прав у Вінніпезі.
I do not believe that foreign intellectuals or writers or historians should be telling us what we have to have or not have in one of our museums. That's just not on. Okay? It's just not on. I will be a courageous voice for the Ukrainian community, not only about the Holodomor, but also as I am a financial supporter and a vocal supporter of the monument to the victims of communism.
You know, I've been a supporter of greater recognition of the Holodomor. I certainly wrote to the Canadian Human Rights Museum in support of the Ukrainian community and having a permanent recognition and display of the history of Ukraine and the Holodomor, and I was pleased, for example, to join in Ottawa for the last Holodomor commemoration day and to speak on behalf of the New Democratic Party. I'm president of the New Democratic Party, and so I was there representing the support of New Democrats across the country for greater recognition and education about the Holodomor.
Not enough people recognize it, not enough people know about it. And therefore, when we're going to build a Canadian Museum of Human Rights, and in Winnipeg of all places, we're home to one of the largest Ukrainian-Canadian communities, it's the place where Canada can make a contribution to people's understanding, because there's been so little exposition of the problem of Holodomor that it's only right. And so we have signed up over 40 members of our caucus have written as groups and individuals to the museum, to the minister, to create a cascading kind of pressure that this is not going to go away, that it's not about people trying to reach into a museum and its decisions, but there has to be some accountability.
Ukrainian Canadians are nation builders. So busy, in fact, that they, 80 years later, only now making their voice heard about that tragic time. I'm totally in favor of the Human Rights Museum displaying the tragic consequences of the Holodomor, where Stalinist purges and other communist ill effects have occurred. Definitely, let's air this out, let it be known, let awareness be higher.
It's just something that happened in our history together, and by creating these memorials and by just discussing them. I see in places like Rwanda, forgiveness is what happens, and we can protect the future from having to endure something that we, like, it just pains. Sometimes I walk down the street, my heart just goes like that, because you can see it written on the faces of people, in the hearts of families.
Зараз поодинчо розглянемо, яке відношення цих головних партій до українського громадського життя в Канаді.
Перше, розглянемо консервативну партію Канади, яка з історичної точки зору впродовж років постійно виявляла прихильність до української громади.
Під час урядування консервативної партії Канада без вагання визнала незалежність України. А сьогоднішній консервативний уряд виділив відшкодування за злочин інтернування канадійців східноєвропейського походження. Викликав одноголосне проголошення парламенту Канади, що Голодомор – це геноцид проти українського народу, та під час державної візити до України наперекір бажань президента і уряду України консервативний прем'єр-міністр Канади Гарпер вшанував в Києві пам'ятник Голодомору і відважно відвідуючи загрожений Український католицький університет та музей Налонського у Львові, оборонив поняття свободи слова і преси в Україні.
I helped with the Prime Minister's visit to Ukraine. We talked about the agenda. We were very concerned about where democracy is heading in Ukraine. We were very concerned about academics and others that were coming under increasing amount of pressure. The Prime Minister's speech I helped shape, and we were very concerned that the message got through, that as long as democracy continued to flourish in Ukraine, Canada will of course support Ukraine, and the Prime Minister was very, very clear in his message when he visited Ukraine.
Консервативний уряд і його міністри приділяють особливу увагу до українського громадського життя.
It's a pleasure to meet you because I feel very close to Canada's Ukrainian community. You know that as Minister for Multiculturalism, I have instituted a special award for excellence in the promotion of multiculturalism, calling it the Paul Yudzik Award, because Paul Yudzik was a son of Ukrainian immigrants from the prairies, who was the first Eastern European Canadian appointed to the Senate by John Diefenbaker. And Paul Yudzik was the first to call suggest the idea of multiculturalism as a way of describing Canada.
All through my life, I have had so many Ukrainian friends, and I have seen how they have worked so hard to build our country from the very beginning of our country. The Ukrainian people have opened up Western Canada, built Canada in every region. And in Hamilton, they worked side by side with my friends and relatives in the factories in Hamilton.
Прем'єр-міністр Канади Гарпер вповні обзнайомлений із недотягненнями Державного музею людських прав у Вінніпезі.
I think it is important that if we're going to talk about major, you know, genocides, human rights violations around the world, that there be some equivalency of treatment of those things.
На відгук на застереження Конгресу українців Канади консервативний уряд призначив українця доктор Линді Легодовський до керівництва музею. За визначений національний вклад у справу розвитку українсько-канадської громади, Конгрес українців Канади призначив вручення Шевчуківської медалі прем'єру-міністру Канади Стівен Гарперу на урочистому вечорі, який в останній хвилині був відложений через назначення, власне, цього виборчого періоду.
But this year has been particularly difficult because of the political situation. The Ukrainian-Canadian community will know well that I was invited to accept a major award from the Ukrainian-Canadian community, a big dinner on Friday, March the 25th. But because the parliament voted us down in government, I was not able to use a government aircraft to fly to the event.
На федеральному рівні нова демократична партія особливого відношення до українського громадського життя в Канаді не має. Але на рівні політичної округи Parkdale-High-Park колишній член парламенту цієї округи Пегі Неш хоче відвоювати своє місце. Пегі Неш радо підтримувала проголошення парламенту відносно Голодомору і активно сприяла діяльності суспільної служби, яка знаходиться в цій виборчій окрузі.
Well, Parkdale High Park really is a collection of communities, and we try to reach out in different neighborhoods with different approaches. We have a large Ukrainian-Canadian community here. People know me as being a strong supporter of the Ukrainian community. I just recently wrote a letter to the Canadian Human Rights Museum calling for the Holodomor display to be a permanent display. I spoke in Ottawa on the commemoration of the Holodomor, the national commemoration, and people know me as having been an election volunteer and supporting the community. And whether it's reaching out to seniors and advocating an increase to the Canada Pension Plan, or whether it's working with homeowners and telling them we would take the HST off of their home heating. Well, a lot of people are not happy with the direction that Mr. Harper is taking the country. They're concerned about the way their tax dollars are getting spent, whether it's for fighter planes or corporate tax cuts. And they see the Liberals as supporting Mr. Harper time and time again. Whereas, you know, the NDP is the only party that opposed the HST, and we're really trying to focus on making life more affordable for Canadians. I speak with a lot of seniors who are struggling with very low pension income. They're struggling with high heating costs. We're talking to parents who are really struggling to make ends meet, students that have high debt. So our view is that we need to just reallocate our expenditures so that we're investing more in making life affordable for the average Canadian and not giving big tax cuts to the banks so that they can spend hundreds of millions of dollars in bonuses for executives that are already very well paid. We try to reach out to the needs of different parts of the community. We have an army of volunteers. We have Ukrainian speaking, Tibetan speaking, Portuguese speaking, so people from different ethnic backgrounds. We have young, old, students, seniors, and we try to reflect the diversity of this great urban setting in the volunteers we have. And you can see our signs behind me. We have these bright orange signs all over the neighborhood. We have an army of sign volunteers putting them in. We try to keep up with all the requests we have. And, you know, a campaign is serious. It's about electing political representatives, but we try to make sure we have some fun at the same time.
Найбільш проблематичною партією для української